And welcome back, folks. Welcome back to Let's Play Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde. Still haven't beaten the game, obviously, but last time we got even further, even closer to winning the game, I think. In any case, I do feel now somewhat comfortable playing this stage. And I don't mind these barrels so much anymore, and I don't even mind the purple guy, because I have figured out that by adopting the strategy of first of all taking my time, avoiding these barrels and avoiding the bomb blast by jumping to the left, yeah, I can basically competently play and predictably make progress, and yeah, so this game doesn't feel as much, doesn't feel like so chaotic as it did before, so yeah. Okay. Actually, thing I struggle the most now with, surprisingly enough, are the higher stages, because if I would have beaten the last higher stage of the last video, well then, I think I might actually have been able to complete this level, because I mean, I don't know how long this level is, but I think that we were actually pretty much at the end, so this was stupid. And well, I never had that happen. I gotta take a look at the well, not the source code, but I mean the game code. So last time I well, and I never had that happen either. But this might actually have been a problem with the emulator, and I hope that this actually does not well, lead to audio-video sync issues. So last time I came up with, well, a project for myself that, given one fine day, I might actually try. This project would be to basically fix all the bugs and glitches in this game, like the speed up glitch, the bomb, moving bomb glitch, and all the other glitches, and yeah, also fix the controls, which are somewhat laggy. This would be something I'd be really interested in. Of course, I'm not at all familiar with programming for the NES. But I guess that it's... I mean, I guess that you can learn this very quickly. I mean, I don't really have to program anything. Just modify existing code a little bit. For example, the stair glitch. Oh yeah, I forgot to mention the stair glitch, which is of course the most annoying glitch of the game. So something like the stair glitch, you just have to figure out basically, well, so there seems to be something wrong with the collision detection. So it's a bug that you need to figure out. So it's basically a puzzle. And you don't really need to understand anything about, say, how to optimize. So I think what would be very difficult if you were to try to create an NES game from scratch. Because, well, first of all, creating a game from scratch is obviously something difficult, but so this hardware of the NES is of course very limited, and back in the days it was probably even more the case than it is now, that you really need to understand the intricate details of the hardware for which game is programmed in order to have it perform reasonably well. And this would probably be very difficult to get to know all these intricate details. For instance, if you want to synthesize sound, I guess this would be very difficult, but just finding, basically squashing bugs, this seems something that's doable. And actually, since I've now talked about this so much, I'm actually really interested in trying to figure that out. I mean, yeah, but okay. And yeah, so my main problem right now is just getting more competent at beating the hide stage. This is the main problem for me right now. Okay, and now the dog for some reason seems to always spawn early. Yeah, this game is weird. I mean, also, now that I take my time with avoiding these barrels and try to enjoy this gameplay loop, well, I'm not as annoyed as I used to be, and I don't really mind playing this game at all right now. I don't even really need to pay any attention. Or don't pay so much attention to it. You can really zone out while you're playing this game. Once you have mastered, well, the basic gameplay, and I still don't know whether I would be able to say the same thing about the fourth level, which, as you may recall, contains this very annoying beginning section where you're just completely you're bombarded by these peasants, so at least, yeah, so at least this level I sort of have figured out now, and I will beat this eventually. The only thing that I'm worried about is that eventually I will have made too much progress as Mr. Hyde, and then yeah, I'm pretty much screwed. So if this happens, yeah, I don't know. So come on. One thing that is I've noticed, which is somewhat surprising, is it seems that whenever these jumping brain enemies spawn, no other enemies spawn. As if the game was trying to be, well, give you a break. Which generally it doesn't. But in this regard, it, well, seems to want, yeah, to make your life a little easier, I guess. I jumped too late there, so you definitely want to have a certain height. So here, see, I did not actually receive any effect of the bomb blast. So I think the time when you should jump is a little bit before the fuse. So as soon as the sound of the fuse burning off starts, but before the burning fuse is actually shown, I think this is the correct time at which you should jump. Okay, the dog. Again, the dog. Okay. Well, seems to now be placed right where this bad singer is. So before it was somewhat later, now it's as if the game was adjusting its difficulty. But I don't think that this game is as sophisticated. And then suddenly the brain jumped higher than it did before. Okay. I mean, if you are still surprised by this game's bullshit, then you haven't been paying attention the last, I guess, 18 or 19 episodes. This game is bullshit. We're still not quite at the bridge, and so see, we have learned another thing, and this does seem to be really correct. The correct time on which to jump is precisely when this burning noise starts to play. We are out of time, but I'm going to continue nonetheless. And I jumped prematurely there. Yeah. Yeah, so the correct time to jump is now. So this game actually can be mastered. Just have to be patient. And still the game is hard. I mean, there's just no way about this. This is a hard game. I mean, I don't really actually have played that much NES games, so I don't really know how hard NES hard is. The last NES game that I played was actually this puzzle game. I forgot its name. Bubble Bobble, yeah. So this, I bought the NES Mini, and I'm dead, yeah. And this was the first game that I played, Bubble Bobble, which I also haven't completed yet. In any case, when we'll come back, folks, well, we might at least complete this game. I hope. So until next time, until then.